Let's set this up. So this is going to be my personal Hobonichi weeks for 2023. So just a few things for decorating it later on. We'll set up the yearly view first. So just to give you an idea, I'll be using this to track income flow. I'll be using these stickers. We can cut this into three parts, or maybe by quarter. So you can use these ones. Just to mark 7th, 15th, 22nd. And 30th. And do the same for the other side. So we'll do total from work, W. B for bonuses. I for any interest rate. Maybe at the fifth mine, we'll just do grand total. GT. So just so we can track all cash flow coming in, it's going to help us better appreciate the kind of provision that we receive. Now moving on to our monthly, just using this planner, I want to track birthdays. So just referencing my old, my 2022 planner, just set that aside, using this as reference. See that better? So just birthdays on here. Okay, so since this is my boyfriend's gift to me, what I'll use the weekly part for, well, I'm not going to prepare them. It's going to mainly be a journal of sorts for our days spent together. Just some highlights of what we went through. And every end of the week, I will make use of this right side to serve as a journal, just to assess how I am, how we are, what things I can improve on as a partner, as a person, and the things that we could improve on as a couple. And on the notes section of my week's regular, I will just prepare a quick index page on this side. We'll mainly use this one for a series of ratings, collection of films, series, books, and any other media that we share together. Maybe even restaurants that we visited, food that we ate. So everything will be here. So the idea of this planner is sort of to encapsulate our entire year together. So just fully trusting that, you know, the two of us will share this entire year together. Otherwise, I can still continue this using this planner. And also, just to add, I didn't mention it earlier, I'm not entirely sure what I will be using the monthly view for yet. I don't want this to be an area for our schedules or whatnot. Instead, I might make use of this as like a collection of icon stickers. So if you aren't already familiar yet, I make use of Kina prints, icon stickers, just to indicate like what I do with our day predominantly. So if the day predominantly had to do with work, so we'll put index stickers. And my general plan is to keep each date or each box to a maximum of 4 icon stickers. So that's something I'm looking forward to trying out for 2023. So other than that, I will just have to decorate the front of this and transfer or put in this extra pocket. And that's it for my week's regular. All right, so just continuing on, this time I will be setting up my week's mega. So it's this one. For this particular video, I'll only show how I'm going to set up these two. I won't show the take a note A5 yet, the day free, or the kinbor. So just the two Hobonichi weeks. So for this one, I've already actually decorated the cover portion and then included the extra pocket. So now let's start with the yearly. Okay, so since this week's mega will be my everyday carry and I ideally just focused on work, I will have to make use of this again as I did in 2022, which was to serve as my attendance tracker, leave tracker for work. So I have to input all the holidays, regular holidays, non-working holidays, on this section, just so I can keep track of my attendance. And I have actually already listed those in a part of my 2022. So on the last page of the notes section, so I already listed those down. Okay. So since I am a government employee, I have to refer to the presidential proclamation order. It's a document that's released listing all the holidays for the following year. So I have those here. Let me just start listing them down. Just so you can see this better. So my week's mega is still in Japanese, but it's relatively easy enough to follow which days these are. Of course, January 1st, even though it's a weekend, you still put that in. And then for April 9th, here, and then April's 6 and 7, Monday, Thursday, and Good Friday. And after April, we'll proceed with May 1. June, Tuft. August. Here. And then November. 30. December 25th, and then December 30. Okay, so these are all the regular holidays, and then we have these special non-working holidays starting with Feb 25. So I just put S and W, and then we have April 8. August 21st is here. And then November 1st. Okay, November 1st. And then November 2nd as well. And then December 31st, despite being a weekend. Still put that in. Alright, so as I did for 2022, this will just track the days I went to work. So I'll also indicate if I took sick leaves, vacation leaves, or any special leaves for a period, and then tally them up here just so I can keep track of how many leaves I've used in a year. Right. Alright, so for this planner in 2023, I will mainly use the monthly area to keep track of all the schedules and important appointments, priorities for the month, for my work specifically. So nothing on my personal life in here, just purely work. I will also likely list the bills to pay on this portion. I think relatively... yeah, this is the area that has the most consistent space I can use to list down my bills for the month. So just so it's easier to track. I will not set this up yet for your eyes because I'm not yet fully sold on the idea. But essentially, overview of events, priorities of the month, mainly for work. Now on the weekly portion, so starting in January, so what I'll do here, similar to my current setup, is I will have to put in Monday through Saturday on this top portion, and then just list here all my tasks, work, errands actually, though those are personal, they are still something I consider to be tasks or not really relaxing time. So I still have to do groceries, laundry, steam my clothes, etc., clean the condo, all here. So I won't set it up yet again, just I don't want to have to put in too many things on my planners at this time. It's still in November of 2022, and I want to take my time to maybe think about it still, because a lot can change from today up to the entirety of December. So I don't want to commit to anything yet, to any particular design or system, but at least I have it in my head that this will be for work and for my errands, my personal errands. Okay, and then on the notes section, so just to add also, I will have very minimal decorations on this one because it's meant to be for work, this planner. So just to limit the distractions that my eyes might see. Okay, and on the notes section, because I got a mega, so the main purpose of this area is to serve as my daily bullet journal. So for those of you who aren't aware, this was a system created by writer Carol. You can actually look for that online, bullet journaling, and there are so many different ways to do it now, but I suggest going to the origin of it, which is writer Carol's version. So I will keep this very, very simple, just to make an index page, the first two pages of the notes section, and then I'll proceed with January on this one. And I will not use the monthly overview or month at a glance kind of page. I will not add future logs here or whatever, because that is the purpose of the weekly area. So this will serve as my future log area. And of course, my monthly overview will be on the monthly section. But this one is just for daily bullet journaling. So just to keep track of all my tasks and everything as they come. It'll be easier to use this in my workplace, because after spending a year where I work, I found out that there are lots of sudden tasks that I have to handle on a daily basis. So the bullet journal system is very, very flexible and can actually help support me in keeping track of my progress, keeping track of all my tasks, and making sure that I don't forget any of them. Right, so that's basically it for this one. There might be parts that I will not use, because mainly, since this is mainly for work, I'm unsure how I'll use the My 100. I might use this for, I don't know, projects that I'll do for this year, but that's actually stretching it. I will probably not do 100 different projects for the upcoming year at work. So I'll see what I'll use this for, but I might not use it, because the idea of this planner is just to be for work. So nothing sentimental, nothing personal on here. All right. So that's it for my video. I just quickly set these two up. I will probably have another shorter video just to show you how I'll decorate this one. I already have the materials prepared here anyway, and just additional deco on the other pages. But mainly, again, work, personal. So I like to keep everything separate now, because it's been crazy in 2022 having to keep everything in one planner. So prioritization will be easier when I am able to separate the aspects of my life. So that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I am so sorry I limited the chattiness on this one. Some people actually prefer it if I don't talk and if I just do what I want to do on the planner. And I guess some people are auditory learners, some of you are visual learners, but I hope I am able to cater to both of you. And for those of you who are, I think it's kinesthetic, those of you who learn by doing it on your own, I think it'll be good to actually decorate or set up your own planners with me while you're watching this YouTube video. And I hope that helps you too. So take care, everyone. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.